And Michael is very keen, as he said earlier on, to ensure that we get maximum use of the terrain. So he certainly put the terrain back in Gawler. And we have news now that the next course is on course. That's Magistrate number 49.
Yes, 17 is here.
Getting off at 11:08 and 30 seconds precisely. About 2 or 3 seconds to go, and Bold Regent will be away. Bold Regent on course now, and we've still got Mr. and Magistrate still on the cross-country course. Mr., up to fence number 12, travelling kindly, no problems, and behind him, Magistrate, up to fence number 8. Bold Regent, over on the other side of the course, we certainly know, passed safely over fence number 1, and Mr. starting to wend his way home over the A&B, the state back. Now, 49, at fence number 11, the information we're getting here is had one refusal and has then jumped clear. Magistrate is the horse that you see coming along the riverbed now, approaching the Cajamardio wall, and safely over that one. Now, getting back to Mr., clear up to fence 14. Magistrate pushing them closely, of course, and they may in fact overtake, but they've got that big hill to go yet. Just looking down at our list, Bold Regent, clear over fence number 7. And Bold Regent is the next horse that you'll see coming down to the parallel bar.
61 refusal.
Three horses on course at the moment. Mr., first horse to start, followed by Magistrate and then Bold Regent. Bold Regent is the horse coming down the top of the hill. And we've got number 56, Legato, in the starting box right up at the top of the hill. Bold Regent safely over the parallel bars and going the long way around there. 52, clear up to fence number 8 now. And Legato has...
Fence 18, 60, clear.
And now, number 56, Legato. Clear fence number 5. So that horse will be coming into view very shortly too. Now 56, over on the other side of the course, clear over fence number 6, that's Legato. 52 is Bold Regent.
60 has jumped.
And we have the word Mr. safely home. I don't know whether that's clear without penalty. 16:40. Well, 49 we know has cleared 17, so we've got Magistrate getting fairly close to home. The horse sweeping down the hillside now is number 56, that's Legato. That's the horse coming down the hillside, approaching the bonnet's hut.
This is control, over. Fence 18 is to control.
Legato coming along the riverside now, down in the creek bed. Certainly look good over the Cajamardio wall. Now we've got two horses complete. That's Mr. and Magistrate, number 52, which is Bold Regent. Clear up to fence 16. 56, which was Legato. According to me, Legato is up to fence number 13. And it looks as though this course is going to jump well for novice horses. I think our course horse builder Michael Creever would be certainly very pleased with this. Now, 56, we've just had the news, they're clear up to fence number 13, which is the A&B State Banks. And choosing to come across the gully, or go down into the gully, and try and save a little bit of time there. As I look back here, Bold Region approaching home, one fence to go. And we've got 58, better or beta, whichever you like, in the starting box up at the top of the hill.
In 20.
58 is beta. That's the next horse that will come down to the parallel bars up on the top of the hill.
Finish, this is control.
And at this stage, we have only two horses on course. 55, JWG and beta. JWG, according to me, the best we can make of it here, up to fence number 11. 12 must be right, 13 is right. And now we've got beta, number 58. Down over the top of the hill, 57, beta. Choosing to come round and come in over the panel. That's a safer option for novice horses. Now, Ant Pants, up to pitch number 4. Travelling kindly is the information that we're getting.
I need an ambulance, fence 16, I have a fall. We have an ambulance, it's alright, we have one.
Down in the water, clear of the, over that first obstacle.
Fence 16 is the fence, all right?
And all I have to do is jump back into it again and come up the track.
The area is blocked at the moment. We cannot accept another horse.
Beta is the horse that you see coming along, number 58. Coming along the creek bed this morning, or the creek flat, right in front of the cliffs here. They've got to several fences to go, of course, but as you notice, most of the novice horses looking really good. Now, 58, clear up to fence number 12, and 57, Ant's Pants. That'll be the horse to come down over the hillside shortly and down to the big parallel bars. That's the next one we'll see.
Just carrying out minor repairs to the fence. Control right.
The fall at fence 16. 16, in fact, is A, B, C and D, the zigzag and the steps. We don't have complete information. And we'll just have a little bit of a spell here. Just dropped in over the bank there, no problems. Belvidere has safely negotiated the 10th obstacle, that's Dead Man's Pass, and they've got another one there as well. That's safely negotiated. 57. We're now up to number 15 and 16. Let's get back to our information. Hans Pants, getting close to home now. We don't have any news on fence number 15. That seems to be a bit of a problem, but it's an electrical problem more than anything else. Hans Pants, clear up to fence 17. Clear up to number 13. That's the best information we've got for you at the moment. Kyber Medallion, cross the parallel bars, no pinpoints. They're choosing to go through the bonnet's hut and make a sharp left-hander and then just slide down the bank and take that little track that appears to the left of Bonnet's hut. Kyber Medallion down at the water, safely dropping in over the bank. That'll be the next horse to come into view. The information is, jumped everything so far.
457, set, wait. Set, 18.
Number 50, Boulder Bender, clear over fence 18. And 54, Quattro. Clear over fence number 7, so we'll be, that horse will be coming into view very, very shortly. 54 is Quantra, written by Carla Wenicke. And 59, Will Poringa Sage, Gavin Ramsey on board, on course at the moment. Now Quantra, number 54, taking advantage of the downhill run, making up a little bit of time. Will Poringa Sage, safely over that first fence. And Kyber Medallion approaching home, safely over fence number 16. Now Carla Wenicke on Quantra.
Is horse 50 correct weight?
Before she approaches the next
fence. Correct.
Which is in fact number 9. Next horse that we'll get in our sights up here. And in just a moment, we'll have a little bit of information, I hope, coming in on Will Poringa Sage and fence number 13. Takes them a little while to wind their way along the riverbed. Now, number 59, safely through the State Bank's fence. Marquise is the horse coming down the hill. Sterling Marquise is ridden by Michelle Bastian. Their dressage score on the previous days. Just let's have a look. 70.8, 24, about halfway down the list. They're going to come, go over the fence panel at the end of Bonnet's Hut. Sterling Marquise, clear over fence number 9. Sage, still waiting to hear whether that horse in fact has completed. Eight was fine for the Thomas. That was the big parallel bars just down from the top of the hill. The Thomas in fact is ridden by A. Brewer. Their dressage score 63.9 and they were 13. Sixty-five is on course at the moment. Just had the start. 65 is Centenary. In the meantime, it's the Thomas that should come into view. Coming along the river flat now. Safely negotiated up to number 11. And certainly stood off well from the Cajamario wall. Made it look easy.
16 62
clear. Now back to 62, Sterling Marquise. Clear over fence number 16. The Thomas, working his way safely along the riverbed, cleared the Cajamario wall number 65, yes, that's the horse we'll see shortly. They've crossed the road, clear over fence number 7. Sterling Marquise, they're clear over fence number 17. They're approaching home. Two fences to go for Sterling Marquise, and coming down the hill is...
Thank you.
Riverside Chips Rapidly, number 66, safely over the first fence. And the second, the Corwood Pile, safely negotiated for that horse. Right in front of us, we've got number 65, which is in fact Centenary. Australian horse, clear over 16. And we've got Necromancer, had the start, number 12, and Necromancer, approaching fence number 8. Don't forget, our major sponsors here today, Foundation South Australia. Necromancer coming into view now, up on top of the hill. Necromancer, Shane, seconds ago. Kilty, 70, on course. In the meantime, Necromancer approaching Bonnet's Hut. Kilty, safely over the first fence. Necromancer coming in over the end panel. Mr. Gable, we've missed him out of wrap because he swished his tail two or three times after landing. But they're a good way away and it's pretty hard to chill. Now, number 70, Kildy, that was the horse that you saw come along the riverbank, clear through with the state banks, number 13. At the start and safely over the first four fences. Professor Paddington, 72, clear over 5. And 71, safely through number 10 in the water. And it looks to me safely over the next element as well. There's safety. And safekeeping, as far as we know, clear over fence number 12. And if we go back to Kilty, Kilty is over fence number 18. Now, Ant's Pride in the starting box. 71, safekeeping, safely through the state banks combination. That is Professor Paddington coming down the hillside, Catherine Fraser on board. Say, hey, we've got to have control because we've got some tricky stuff coming up. And now, let's see what we can find by looking at our list. Safekeeping. As far as we know, clear up to number 15, but we've got a dead spot in our radio communications, and that's not helping us very much. 71, safe clipping, clear over number 16 for the fence and into the water. In fact, he said last year, if he completed Gawler in 1988, he was going to retire. He says he's going to retire all over again. But I just don't believe him. He loves the sport too much. And he's having the time of his life. Ant's Pride, Eddie White, approaching the Bonnet's Hut. As far as we know, clear so far. Now, Professor 3, Ant's Pride, no problems with the water. Eddie White, and Eddie won't mind me saying, he is the oldest rider in the event, I'm sure. Always retiring and always coming back. And now number 74. 74 is Benash. Benash, clear up defence number 4. 73. Ant's Pride, clear over fence number 12. Got in close, but tucked up nicely in front. 72, over the State Banks complex. And 74, Benash, about to come down on the riverside of the course because they're clear over fences 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Number 74, Benash is the horse that we'll be looking for, ridden by Jay Hocking. Handy dressage score of 63. We'll be coming into view any minute. That's Benash. They've crossed the road. message we had had two horses confused. Professor Paddington, we know, is approaching home. And 73, I think they've got it right now. 73 is Anne's Pride. They're clear over 14. And 74, that's Benash coming down the hillside now, clear over their last fence, which was number 8. I think any minute now we'll hear that Professor Paddington has crossed the finish line. As I said, getting close to home, clear over number 16, and we've had the word that 75 is on course. Soft touch, 75, on course and clear over the first fence. 73, Ant's Pride, getting close to home, clear over 16. And in the meantime, it's number 74, Benash. Benash down at the water, and making it look easy. Professor Paddington, very close to home, clear over 17. Now, Anne's Pride has finished the course. Safely over the last fence, Eddie White, Anne's Pride, completed Gawler once again. Soft touch, approaching Bonnet's Hut. Soft touch, written by D. Smith. The dressage score 74.4. Linkville 33rd. They're going to go around and come in over the panel. Safely over that fence. In the meantime, it's Ballymoon Castle that we have on course down on the riverside. Here comes my son, Gaddy. No chance of missing that big white face. I'm talking about the horse. I'm not talking about John Patterson, the rider. And most unusual, a refusal there at number 8 for number 77, my son, Gaddy. 79, we know, is on course. Kimbala alert. Now, it's my son, Gaddy, approaching the Bonnet's Hut. Safely over the panel, decided not to go through the hut. Just weaving his way gently down there. And in the meantime, it's Ballymoon Castle. Approaching the end of the course, clear over 13, 14 and 15. Oh my word, my son Gaddy nearly took a nosedive there. Picked on landing, and John Patterson did well to stay. Kimbara alert is written by Margaret Oliver. That's the horse approaching the Bonnet's Hut. Their dressage score 76.8, 38 after that phase. They certainly looked a good combination as they sweep down the hill. We've had a finish now for Ballymoon Castle. They've completed the course. And 77, my son Gaddy, clear through the State Banks complex. Kimbara alert, approaching number 3 one-day events, and full marks to Margaret. She certainly gets the horse going very, very kindly indeed. Looking as fit as a fiddle as we look down on him here. And beautifully over the Cajamardio Wall. So that's number 79, clear over number 12, Kimbara alert. Further out on the course, 77, we know, is clear over fence 17. And we should be getting the word any moment that Quiros is getting a start. Number 80. But we know that number 81, Freddie Fudd Pucker, is in the starting box at the moment. No, I didn't mispronounce it. That's the horse's name. Freddie Fudd Pucker, number 81. And I just heard a scrap of a radio message there that said 80 has probably been scratched. My son Gary, any moment. Freddie Fudd Pucker completed all of that part of the course on the other side of the grounds. And my son Gary, as I said, clear over the last fence, safely home. I think we'll hear the same about Kimbara alert any moment. Freddie Fudd Pucker, clear over fence number 5. Two fences remaining now for Kinnear. So we should be picking that horse up in our sights. Yes, see, they come down the hill now. Brave Buccaneer, Paul Pritchard on board. Their dressage score 74.4, equal 33rd after that phase. Safely over fence number 8. Freddie Fudd Pucker still on his way, safely over the State Bank's complex, number 13. Clear over the first two fences. Any minute now, I think we'll get the word that Freddie Fudd Pucker has reached home. 82, through the first fence in the water, number 10. And it looks to me like a fall, but I'll wait on the message. Clear over 16. Can't see what's happening down there with the Brave Buccaneer. We just lost contact there for a moment with one of our radio operators, so we can't tell you too much about Master Craftsman. There they are. They've come into view safely over number 8. They'll come down the hill, so we'll leave them for a while and give them time to catch up to and get to Bonnet's Hut. Meantime, Hopscotch. Clear up to fence number 13 and number 85, Camson, clear over fence number 4. Take care, spectators and others. There is a loose horse on the course, and I believe it's 83. The rider of Hopscotch had a fall after number 13. Certainly an interstate horse. Why not? Number 88. by Sally Andrews. Great support from Interstate Horses and Riders. I'm very pleased we are to see that this is, of course, a selection year for Stockholm, the World Series, in next year, 1990. 88, we'll be seeing Fairly Sand. They clear over number 4, and 83, or 84 rather, clear over 13. Why Not, written by Sally Andrews, clear over number 5. And Hopscotch Approaching Home, clear over fence number 16. Camden now coming down into the water, was clear over 9. Why Not approaching us, clear over 6, so they'll be coming out of the road surely. They are calling for the ambulance, or St John's people, at fence number 17. Right in front of us, we've got number 85, Camson, clear over fence number 12. And 84, Master Craftsman, getting close to home, clear at number 16. Good question. Good question. Clear over the first fence. And we've got 88 down in the water. Clear over 9 and clear over 10. 84, according to me, Master Craftsman, clear over fence 17. Must be the rider of Hopscotch. Why Not, clear over fence number 13, the State Banks Complex. And 89, good question, clear over fence number 7. Good question, we'll see coming into view any minute. There they are, running down the hill now. 19, just in case, on course. Just in case, on course, approaching the first fence. Clear over that first fence for just in case. And the second fence, the Corwood pile. Now we have news of number 83, that was Hopscotch. Apparently the rider has remounted and continued on their way. It was a fall after fence 17. Over 8, the big parallel. And Why Not, number 88, has cleared fence number 19 to finish. Good question. Safely through the State Banks Complex. Clear over the first three fences. Just waiting for word on just in case. Can't get a good sight of that fence from here. But clear over 11 now for just in case. Two will be try. They're coming down the hill. Any moment now they should come into view. I just missed them when they get to the loading ramp. But there's no problem there, they're safely over that. And 93, Western Red. Can't give you much information. I know the horse is on course. Safely over the first fence for Western. Mr. Red and Robin Stokes. Just in case, clear 16. 93, Western Red, clear over the first three fences. And it's number 92, try, coming to the bonnet hut, going past the hut, popping in nicely over the panel for 8. 95, Northern Waters is about to get a start. Very interesting history to Northern Waters and Anne Hodson, who is the rider. And 92, that was the horse that just went over fence 12, is safely through the State Banks complex, and we've got Western Red, number 93, over fence number 5. Through the ford, coming to obstacle number 10, a simple drop down into the water, and Robin's going for the stick and saying, hey, we've got to go down there. And I would imagine that would be scored as a refusal. 25, safely over at the third attempt. Northern Waters approaching the Bowman's Hut now. They've got about, 300 or 400 metres to go. Now Western Red, safely over number 13 and 97, clear over number 5. So we'll be seeing simulcast very shortly. In the meantime, the next horse to come down to the water will be... Can't quite see what's happening down there with Northern Waters, but I think she's jumped in. She's clear over number 11. Well, ladies and gentlemen, give her a big hand as she goes away from us, because that's a rider who is making history to compete 30 years ago and then to back up again today. Well done, Anne Hodson. Well done, Northern Waters. Now, simulcast is the horse that we'll see soon. 93, Western Red, we know, is up to fence number 16. It looks like they've completed that. Simulcast, well and truly on its way, clear over fence number 11. As I said, this horse is for sale, so if you have an interest, go along and see Samantha Stitchell at the end of the day. Clear over number 12. That was the Cajamario wall. In the meantime, 98. Peppermint Grove, clear up to fence number 5. And Western Red, slowly made up to fence number 6. At number 14. That's Northern Waters, has had a stop at number 14, the golfer's staircase. And Peppermint Grove we'll see coming in right at Jill Rolton. Peppermint Grove is the grey horse coming down the hill now. The rider's Jill Rolton. Jill, of course, was the big winner of the advanced section here last year on Benton's Way. And this one's a novice horse that she's bringing along. Now, Northern Waters, we know, clear up to fence number 16. I think simulcast right behind them, clear over the same fence. Meantime, Peppermint Grove coming down to the water. They were clear over hear John Tennant on the loudspeakers. He's letting us know that simulcast has finished, so is Northern Waters. And simulcast almost overtaking Northern Waters on the line. But I bet there'll be great rejoicing in the Northern Waters camp tonight. Well done, Ann Hodgson. Congratulations to you from us all. And that, in fact, has cleared that horse, number 101, has cleared number 10. Made short work of the Bonnet's Hut and the Snowy River Lead. And Lockley's Pride, clear over 11 as well. And 103, we know, is out on the other side of the course, but they've negotiated the first five fences with our system here. So I don't have a complete picture of where all our horses are just at the moment, but we'll pick that up shortly, and we'll bring that back to you in just a moment. Number 103, pack them in. That's the horse that's coming down the hillside now. Pack them in. Ridden by R. Lamb, they're approaching fence number 8, they're safely over. 101, Lockley's Pride, clear through the State Bank complex. The two elements there, and just looking up the hill there at Packham Inn. Safely through the Bonnet's Hut, just going to drop into the water at number 10. No problems there. And Webber and Ben, number 104, cleared the first four fences. And number 104, Webber and Ben, now clear up to fence number 6. We're getting towards the end of the novice section, of course. Safely negotiated the State Bank double. And Lockley's Pride. Webber and Ben, of course, that's the grey horse that you just saw jumping fence number 8. Comes down the hill now. Safely over the State Bank complex. slide. And 108, Chanakai, we know, is clear up to fence number 5. Diamond Pit, moving on to fence number 13. That's the State Bank complex, two elements, A and B. And Harriman. Harriman has cleared 16. Chanakai, cleared fence number 6, must be moving along fairly smartly. Chanakai, well in view now, has cleared fence 8. Chanakai, from a show jumper. Can't be absolutely certain, but I think he went to B grade in his show jumping career. And now Julie Heron has taken him over and turned him to a beating.
Trouble at all. allow us to head clear fix number 9 and travelling along nicely, so we know there are no problems there as far as we can tell. At 35, Strout, Louise Cooter in the starting box. That's the horse that must really give it a big sight here today, I think. Certainly would be the favourite as far as the South Australian horse is concerned. The same horse that I was just talking about, the number 30, Barris Cutting. In the meantime, we've got a Lara Silk, head out again, and that's beautifully done. Strauss certainly showing how the reputation has been acquired. This season, unbeatable. Certainly is going to destroy the company. Safely over the big oxer. And they go on now to the... when I say that, doesn't mean they've had no penalties. That's the information we have at the moment, that they're up to that particular fence. Now up to 24, Lara Silk. And Strauss carrying on the 9th. And Illabra, safely over the first fence, the Blue Kings. Strauss now moving on the home. They're safely over the Bentley case, which would be SA. SA is written by Jason Gardam. Jason and SA certainly got it together pretty well at Ranella Championship, or Australia Championship, in fact, one day event, and placed there. And now, Woodmount Enterprise, number 38. Bowling along nicely. They're clear over 1980. Down to the Bentley Gates, over that. They've got 23 and 24, very close together in front of them. And it's rising as well. And unfortunately, yes, they dragged the back legs a little bit. But he looks to be well bandaged behind, so probably took him out of half there. First element. Now Snap, clear over number 10. So that means we'll be seeing them before long. They're over Ears Rocks. And Crimson. Clear over the jump that's caused a few problems for the advanced horses. That's the cross question. Clear over number 3. And 44. Snap moving along now to number 11. Over that. And come over this side of the road. And in the meantime, SA, clear over 19 Avery in the Bay Bank 6. hat down the neck just as they landed after the big brush fence. Dress rehearsal, up to number 10. Safely me through the hut, down the slide. Cool down to the water, and I think there's been a fall, yes. The rider has been dislodged. Harrison, clear over there's rock. So they'll move to the brush and drop down. And come across onto our side of the course. In the meantime, Mr. Quincy, clear over 17 A, B and C. They're up to fence number 21. And 12, Harrison. Clear at 12 and 13. That's the Bonnet's Hut, the Snowy River Lead. They've had a stop there at the first of the jumps into the water. That's at 14 A and B. Sunhill Sport now, moving up to Ayers Rocks at a negotiated Walsh's seat. Any minute we'll hear that Stuart Buntine and Plantagenet have cleared 17 A, B and C, which they just have. And Sunhill Sport. Guy Schaefer, a Gawler veteran, without question. She's approaching the Bonnet's Hut. In the meantime, number 14 approaching 21. That's the launching place. And going through that Bonnet's Hut must feel like a bit of a launching place. Sunhill Sport safely through. Over the Snowy River lead. And 15. That's Sunhill Sport. They're clear through the Slope Banks complex. That's 17 A, B and C. And Sunhill Sport moving along strongly. They're over the Bentley Gates. So they're running downhill now. State Bank's three elements, and 22. That's looking good. 22 and looking... 22, looking good. They're up to fence number 9. That's the brush and drop. That brings them over the road onto our side of the course. And we've had the word, yes, Al Tammy, clear over 17 A, B and C. A little bit of a problem there for number 22. They're moving on. They're clear over fence number 9. Riders and strappers, everyone else involved with them. State Bank Complex and Atlantic City. Can't tell you what there. But certainly they've had the start. They're over the first fence. And as soon as we have something further, we'll pass that on. Looking good. Clear over 22 and 23. So three fences remaining for them.
Score of 73.8. Could we have urgently to the area near the men's toilet Graham Parham, Dot Cleland, Jimmy Scanlon and Wayne Roycroft. They are required urgently for the parade near the horse-drawn vehicles area. Urgently, Graham Parham, Dot Cleland, James Scanlon, Wayne Roycroft.
Thank you.
Fallout was most unfortunate for Trevor and Riverside Trips Rafferty. We'll have the score there in a moment. Meanwhile...
Yes, number 90, Justin Case, Jackie Baker from South Australia.
Dressage score of 66.9. Perfectly clear, then, on the endurance phase yesterday. So they enter with a score of 66.9, and they are in fourth position. Unfortunately for Trevor, 35 jumping penalties, no time penalties. And that gives him an overall score of 94.1. Now, quickly again, we were looking for Graham Parham, Wayne Roycroft, Dot Cleland, and Jimmy Scanlon to the horse-drawn vehicle area up near the men's toilet. Urgently, please.
Throw the rubbish in the back as well. Yeah.
Third drive past the what's
The next combination over from Victoria, number 64, the Thomas, the rider Amanda Brewer.
Dressage penalty of 63.9, clear on roads and tracks and steeplechase, 0.8 of a time penalty on cross country, no jumping penalties, 64.7, third position. And for number 90, just in case, clear on time, clear jumping, retain 66.9, and well, we'll wait and see whether it's still fourth position.
Sounds good, bro. Put your back in front of us, Craig.
Just two accommodations left in the novice. The next is number 98 from South Australia, Peppermint Grove, Gillian Rolton.
Dressage penalties are 49.8. They were clear on steeplechase and roads and tracks. Clear jumping on cross country, but had 9.6 time penalties, which gives them a total score of 59.4, and they are in second position as they enter the arena. Number 64, the Thomas, no time faults, 10 jumping penalties, 74.7. Now, there's no doubt these last 8 to 10 places will be changing somewhat, and we'll bring those to you towards the end of the day when we announce all of the place getters.
And the final competitor in our novice section is from Victoria, number 53, Kebab Medallion, and the rider Julia Gibson.
Kebab Medallion has a dressage penalty of 53.4, and another very sound performance all around yesterday brings them through without 1 point being scored against them. They enter the arena in first position with a dressage score, jumping, cross-country steeplechase, the whole works, 53.4. 98, Peppermint Grove, clear on time, clear on jumping, retain their place of 59.4. Thank you.
They want me. Because I got money.
Just wait on the score now from the judges, and it takes a moment to be passed into us. But from what we can see here, probably clear. And it was clear time, clear jumping. So they retain their score of 53.4 and probably retain first position. Peter Horridge to the microphone point, please. Peter Horridge. The first thing, ladies and gentlemen, we would ask you, please, no applause at this stage so that we do not cause any problem with these horses in harness. I think you'll appreciate that it's far better to retain the health of the people who are in the vehicles rather than, at this stage, give them the accolade which they deserve. So no applause, please. In vehicle number one, we have for you Mrs. Vicky Mackay, Dr. Doug Mackay, Mr. Graham Parham, Dr. Gordon Mackay, and Major Jack Cawley. They are five of the original members of the Gawler Three Day Event Committee. And Anne Edicote is driving a wagonette owned by Carol Lindner of St. Hallett Wines. This vehicle has been restored by Mike Kerry. The vehicle is used for parades, promotional work, and is also available for hire for weddings. The two horses are part-bred Cleveland Bays, Bess and Rose. In vehicle two, we have Dot Cleveland.
Yes, Chris Kerry is driving the yellow sporting-type vehicle made from odds and ends by Mike Kerry, and this is used in shows and combined driving as well. The pony, a 14-year-old pony, named Petite Beau.
In vehicle three, we have now some of the original winners, or the winners of the Gawler three-day event. The one and only Bill Roycroft, who won, I think, some seven Gawler three-day events in the varying classes, and Frank Patterson. Frank in those days was a sergeant instructor in the mounted police, and he rode, I think it was police horse Apollo.
This vehicle, driven by Frank Whitfield, was built by Duncan and Fraser in Franklin Street, Adelaide, around 1900, around the turn of the century, and was used for general use and Sunday pleasure drives. It's been restored from an old wreck by Mr. and Mrs. Whitfield at Two Wells.
In vehicle four, we have Margaret Clark, who was also a member of the original committee.
The pony carriage with Margaret is over 100 years old and was imported by Don and Pat Barkley from Belgium back in 1978, being drawn by a pair of registered Shetlands.
Margaret Clark, of course, has the honour of writing a book and being very mixed up in instruction in South Australia. In vehicle five, we have Wayne Roycroft.
Yvonne Johnson is driving the Newbold Barnaby in a combined driving competition vehicle made by John May of Mount Crawford. The harness was made by V. Love of Murray Bridge.
In vehicle number five, Wayne Roycroft. Wayne is one of the winners of Gawler Three Day Event. Looking down there, he's ridden Valdez in 87. Version 74. In vehicle number six, have James Scanlon and John Vaughan, winners of Gawler. John Vaughan won, in fact, three Gawler three-day events.
Yeah, Kev Kinahan is driving this little Gemma Abbotsmeyer, the Druin, an Irish jaunting cart. The harness was made by Les Matten, member of the Mount Crawford Harness Club.
In vehicle eight, we have, in fact, Ken Gelbart, Scott Keach, and Gillian Rolton.
Yeah, Herb Jackson, a member of the Gawler Plains Harness, is driving a pair of the Hackneys to a covered wagon made by Herb from an old buggy. The cover's been left off today, but has been made for travelling around South Australia and has battery indicators, lights, etc. been modernised. It's very warm and comfortable to travel in and quite dry to sleep in on club camps. The Grey Pony is a past Australian, New South Wales, Queensland, South Australian champion, combined driving champion.
And they are very well supported by members of the Gawler River Pony Club. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please acknowledge that committee with a great deal of foresight and some wonderful winners of Gawler over the past 30 years.
The next competitor into the arena from Western Australia, number 22, looking good, Clayton Fredericks.
Dressage penalty of 87.2. No time faults on the roads and tracks, or steeplechase, no jumping faults. On the cross country, 51.6 time penalties with 160 jumping penalties, with a total score of 298.8 in 13th position, looking good, Clayton Fredericks. Six time penalties, 55 jumping penalties.
The arena now from Victoria, number one, Rum, the rider Margaret McLean.
Rum had a dressage penalty of 84, was clear on steeplechase and roads and tracks. Time penalties 112.4 on the cross country with 60 jumping faults. They're in 12th position with a total score of 256.4. And looking good, had in fact 25 jumping penalties, no time faults. And that should give them approximately 323.8 overall penalties. Thank you.
In the intermediate division, Mr. Quincy is number 11 from South Australia, the rider Bill Roper.
Dressage penalty of 87.8. No penalties on steeplechase or roads and tracks. Time faults of 52.4 on the cross country and 80 jumping penalties. A total penalty for the 2 days thus far, 220.2, and they are in 11th position. Rum was clear on time, had 5 jumping penalties, which gives them, he and Margie, a total of 261.4.
Introducing now into the arena, number 3, Sidekick from South Australia, and Tony Rasmussen, the rider.
Dressage penalty, 100.2. 28 time penalties on roads and tracks, clear on the steeplechase, clear jumping on the cross country, but 52.4 time penalties cross country. They are now in 10th position with a dressage score of 180.6. And Mr. Quincy had 20 jumping penalties, no time penalties, 240.2.
Thank you. Hello.
Now to 27, Atlantic City from Victoria, and the rider, Margaret McLean. Atlantic City has a dressage penalty score of 92.8. 6.4 time faults on the steeplechase, 62.4 time faults on the cross country, were clear on jumping on both the other two phases. A total penalty of 161.6, they are in ninth position. And Sidekick had 10 jumping penalties, clear on time, 190.6. Atlantic City. Dressage penalty of 92.8. Steeplechase, 6.4 time penalties, no jumping penalties. 62.4 time penalties across country, no jumping penalties. Ninth position, total 161.6. David, not many people may know, looking at Margaret riding out there, but she's carrying quite a painful leg injury at the moment.
Yes, I saw her walking the course and certainly wasn't comfortable for her. Number 20, Al Tami, is the next competitor from South Australia, Anton Williams.
Al Tami had a dressage score of 87.6, clear on steeplechase and roads and tracks. There were 20 jumping penalties cross-country, with 36.8 time penalties. The combination are in 8th position with a total score of 144.4, and Atlantic City had no time penalties, 15 jumping penalties, 176.6.
Thank you.
Victoria. Into the arena is number 6, Bertie Worcester, and the rider, Mary Jane Crabtree.
Dressage score was 78.4. They were clear on steeplechase and roads and tracks. They had 20 jumping penalties on the cross country with 42.4 time penalties. They are in 7th position on 140.8 penalty points. Or Tammy was clear on time, 10 jumping penalties, 154.4.
Competitor 15, Sunhill Sport from South Australia, Di Schaefer.
103.8 dressage penalties, 24 time penalties cross country, total score 127.8, 6th position. Julia Gibson has had a large cane basket containing her money, her wallet, her credit cards, a whole lot stolen from her car in the stable area. If anybody happens to see this basket or know anything about it, be delighted to see those persons A, return the basket to the Secretary's office, or let the Secretary's office know any information we can to help Julia recover that basket. Large cane basket containing credit cards, wallet, money, etc., stolen from Julia Gibson's car. We'd very much like to see her get it back. Bertie Worcester, no time faults. 10 jumping faults, 150.8.
Thank you. Introducing now into the arena, number two, Loverboy from South Australia, the rider Scott Keach.
Loverboy at a dressage penalty score of 95.8. Clear roads and tracks and steeplechase. No jumping penalties on the cross country, but 22.8 time faults. They are in fifth position with a dressage score of 118.6. Sunhill Sport, no time faults, 25 penalty points, 152.8.
Introducing now from Victoria, number 24, Lendl, the rider Glenn Dowdy.
Dressage penalty, 94.2, 0.8 of a time fault on the steeplechase, 10 time faults cross country, otherwise clear, third position, total 105. And a Loverboy at 15 jumping faults, no time penalties, 123.6. And the scores I am giving you are purely what I work out and put down on my sheet. They are definitely not the final scores and may be far from correct.
Thank you.
Next from Victoria is number 14, Plantagenet, the rider Stuart Bunteen.
Stuart Bunteen, of course, is the newly appointed director of the Melbourne International 3-Day Event, which we have just been talking about, which we held at Werribee from October the 12th to the 15th. I'm quite sure that Stuart has been picking up some pointers from how to run an event from us here at Gawler. Dressage penalty, 69.8. Clear cross-country and roads and tracks. Clear jumping, sorry, that was steeplechase. Clear jumping cross-country were 20.8 time penalties. They are now in second position with a dressage score of 90.6. Could we have a doctor to the first aid point at the northern end, please? A doctor to the first aid point at the northern end. Jumping penalties, 125.
Thank you.
Now to the last combination in our intermediate class, number 17. Just Fury from Victoria, the rider Stuart Walker.
Just Fury, had a dressage penalty score of 70.6. There were 9.2 time faults on cross country, which gives him a total 79.8 and first position. And unfortunately for Stuart Bunting and Plantagenet, there were 30 jumping faults, which should give him 120.6. May he just still hold on to that position. Shortly.
This completes our intermediate class for the show jumping this afternoon. So we're right on schedule, which is good news. 3 o'clock, we do the walking course of the advanced section. 3:15, the advanced jumping. And about 20 minutes to four, quarter to four, we'll have our presentation. So look at that final score, John.
Yes, for Just Fury. No time faults, 5 jumping penalties, and they complete the 3 days of the competition on 84.8. And on my calculations, that will probably retain him the first position. So that's all we have now from the intermediate class, but I think we have some
raffle, John.
150 time faults on phase A and C. Steeplechase was clear. 33.2 time faults on cross country with no jumping faults. They're in seventh position on a total penalty score of 226.2.
Oh, Trevor, we got peppermint instead.
That's what I went for.
Penalty score of 102.4. They were clear on roads and tracks and on steeplechase. Across country, they had 83.2 time penalties with 20 jumping penalties. They are now in sixth position with a total score of 205.6. And Strauss was clear both on time and jumping faults. They retained the score of 226.2. This means that Robbie Powers has in fact five rails up his sleeve. They were clear roads and tracks and steeplechase. Clear jumping and cross country, but had 77.6 time faults. They are in fifth position with a total penalty score of 147.2. Noble Yen, in fact, had 25 penalty points. Jumping, no time penalties. That gives that combination a score of 230.6.
Now to the next combination from Victoria, number 31, the Lara Silk and the rider Nigel Berry.
Dressage penalty of 68.8. They were clear on steeplechase and roads and tracks. Clear jumping cross country, but they had 68 time faults, which gives them a total score of 136.8. They're in fourth position. And number 28, Night Watchman, was clear on time, but had five jumping faults. 152.5.
The end?
You know that we've got the check, do you?
No.
Or we have. So you don't have to chase the secretary, but Harry picked it up this morning.
Okay.
Happened to be in the office when she was riding around. She said, oh, do ours while I'm here. All right? Oh, that's right.
From Victoria into the arena now, number 45, Frinzen, the rider Delwyn Ogilvy.
Frinzen is, in fact, a stallion. He's the Holsteiner stallion competing here today. He stands at the Ovens district in Victoria. Dressage penalty of 66.6. Clear on roads and tracks and steeplechase. Clear jumping cross country with 57.2 time faults. They come into the arena in third position with a total penalty score of 123.8. And Alara Silk, clear on time, five jumping penalties, 141.8.
Stir him up. Not in public.
I don't often say this later, John, but he is a lovely animal, isn't he?
Yeah, glorious, glorious. Right, next competitor. From Victoria, number 44, Snap, and the rider, Barry Roycroft.
Dressage penalty of 67.4. They were clear cross-country, clear steeplechase and roads and tracks. Clear jumping cross-country, but had 54.4 time faults. They are in second position on a total penalty score of 121.8. And for Frinzen, there were in fact 20 jumping faults. No time faults, 143.8.
Oh. from?
Right, our final competitor in the advanced class is number 38 from Tasmania, Woodmount Enterprise, and the rider Andrew McLean. Dressage penalty score of 86.4, clear roads and tracks and steeplechase. They had 32.8 time faults on cross country with no jumping penalties. They are in first position at the moment on 119.2. Now, Snap was clear on time, had 30 jumping penalties, which gives them an overall score of 151.8.
Which to our computation puts him in first place. Woodmount Enterprise. But we'll have those officially for you. The judges are now working them out, and we're only a few moments away from the presentation with His Excellency the Governor. And we'd like you to stay and applaud the
mounts and the riders who have been entertaining us all the weekend, rather, over the last 4 days. Has been fabulous. Even though the weather wasn't kind the first 2.5 days. So the jump's being removed in front of the official area. And as I said, we're only moments away from the presentation. We would like you to stay. And we've only take a few minutes to present the winners of each class, a word from the organisers, and then it's home for everybody.